who sat busy in his counting house. People used to say Mrs. Scrooge was a cold-hearted, selfish fool. It was none of them things to me. To me, he was, and always would be, my Uncle Scrooge. The city clocks had just gone 3. It was dark already. It had not really been light all day. Mr. Scrooge kept his door open, just in hope that he might keep his eye upon the clerk, the humble Bob Cratchit, who sat in a little sort of tank, a little dismal cell, attending to Mr. Scrooge's every beck and call. Now, Mr. Scrooge, he had a fire, but it made Bob Cratchit's fire look so small, as if it was only one coal. Merry Christmas, Uncle. God save you.
Ah! Humbug!
Christmas a humbug, Uncle. You don't mean that, I'm sure.
I do. What's Christmas time for you? The time for paying bills without the time for finding yourself 1 year older and not now richer. What right have you to be there? What reason have you to be merry?
What reason have you to be so sad? You're rich enough.
Humbug.
Don't be angry, Uncle.
What else can I be when I live in such a world as fools? Merry Christmas. Out on Merry Christmas. If it were up to me, every idiot who goes around with Merry Christmas on his lips should be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stick of holly. It's hard
to be sure. Uncle, you don't mean that.
Oh, nephew! You keep Christmas in your way and allow me to keep it in mine.
You don't keep it!
Let me leave it alone then. What good may it do you? What good has it ever done you?
There are many things in life which I have not profited from, Christmas among the rest. But I have always seen Christmas as a time when it comes around, as a time for giving. A time when men and women are seen as equals, when they're just fellow passengers to the grave. And though it has never put a stack of gold in my pocket, I feel Christmas has done me good and will do me good. And I say, God bless it, Uncle. God bless it.
Are there no visitors?
What are there? Let me just observe.
general impression that situation may have changed. I'm very glad to hear that it has not.
From the impression that they are scarcely furnished, Christians who have mine are but a multitude. The fields are
I wish to remain alone. You ask of me, madame, and that is my answer. I support the establishments that I have mentioned. Because if those are in need, you must go there.
Many can't go there.
You would rather die. You'd rather die. Then hurry up and do it and decrease the surplus population. Now, away with you, vultures! Out, all of you! I am not yet dead, you're already picking me up. Given the festive season, I'm supposing you'll want the whole day off tomorrow.
Well, quite convenient, sir.
Well, it's not quite convenient. And it's not fair. I was to give you half a share of the full day's work. You think to yourself, ill-used. You're up and down, trying to give you a full shilling for half a day's work. Mind the door, Mr. Clatchit! Suppose if you must have the whole day off tomorrow, be here all the earlier next morning.
Excuse them, went home. He just went home, did what he usually does, check his bank books, and go to bed. Now, on this very night, Scrooge. On this very night, Scrooge encountered something completely different. Now let me tell you this. There was nothing in particular about Scrooge's door handle. And it was also a fact that Mr. Scrooge had seen it every morning and every evening. So if somebody can explain this to me, how Scrooge didn't see his regular door knocker that night, but Marley's face. Marley's face. Now there was nothing scary about Marley's face. It was just the fact he was there, staring at Scrooge in the usual unglanced look that he gave him. Scrooge didn't really believe it. He ignored it after a bit of a moment's shock and went to bed. Went up into his room, and he did check behind the door just to make sure there wasn't a pigtail coming out of it or something weird like that.
Damn, man.